Welcome to this guided movement exercise following the method of Feldenkrais awareness through movement. As the title suggests, Feldenkrais method is about increasing awareness of movement through movement. It is not prescriptive, as in finding corrective movements, but it's exploratory in just increasing awareness and functionality of movement that you become aware of. In this one exercise, this is adapted from a student of mine, Stephen Paparo, who went on and was certified in Feldenkrais and started developing his own method that he temporarily called choral ease, all one word, choral ease, and presented at workshops. And he's out east as a professor and now a colleague of mine, and hasn't gone on to develop this method, but these are exercises that he's explored for singing. All right, so first you need to find yourself in a chair, comfortably sitting. We're going to explore the mouth, head, and articulator movements. And you're going to be asked to notice motion, range, and ease, tone, resonance, and placement, and diction clarity and freedom. It should take about 15 to 20 minutes in total if I pace this well. I want you to monitor for quiet, calm, free exploration. Assure yourself at each step to simply explore, notice, and grow in awareness of motion and the results of motion. By this point, I hope you're sitting in a chair comfortably. You can have the back softly against the back of the chair, or sitting up without your back against the chair, depending on where you're sitting. Okay, first, please move your head looking up to the ceiling and then bring it down. Going up with your eyes and coming down with your eyes looking down. Lift and lower. Now this time as you lift and lower, keep your eyes straight out from the head. Looking up, keep this eyes straight out. The view constantly changing as the eyes follow along with the head motion. You're looking straight up as far as the head can go. Now coming down slowly, keeping the eyes straight out ahead. Constantly the view is changing as the eyes follow along with the head motion. One more time, going up, keeping the eyes straight forward, moving with the head. And as you come back down, eyes straight forward, what do you notice? Are the eyes able to smoothly change the same way as the head smoothly changes? Let's try it one more time. Going up, track the eye movement. Is it smooth? Is it improving? Head coming down, keep the eyes. What's the effect of background scenery? Looking with your eyes, the steadiness of your eyes, or not steady? All right, now, with your eyes fixed on a single point straight ahead as you are in resting position, look straight ahead at some object, something right in front of you in your view. All right, now lift your head, keeping your eyes fixed on that one object. Go up as far as you can, still see that one object, and come back down with your eyes still fixed on the one object. Going back up, eyes ahead, fixed on that one object, as far up as you can go, still seeing the one object, and now coming back down, keeping that within view throughout. Resting, looking straight ahead in a comfortable position. Just compare the ease of motion, the eye movement, if you were able to keep it fixed, what difference there was when you were moving your eyes with the head and now moving the head apart from the eye's gaze, the effect of the eyes on movement. Next, we're going to lift the head with the eyes looking ahead of the head movement. Ahead of the head movement. Here we go. Look up, look up, look up, look up, look up, look up. Head goes up, ahead, look ahead. Now looking down, ahead of your head movement, looking down, 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 ahead of your movement. Okay, chin down. Now, looking back, ahead of your, you know, above your head, keep your eyes ahead of head movement, look up, and now looking down ahead of your head movement. One more time, this time making sure you're conscious of the head movement and eye movement combination, the effects of each. Here we go. Look up, 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 ahead. Keep your eyes ahead, keep your eyes ahead. And now look down ahead of head movements. Look down, look down, look down, look down. And now rest. Head straight out, comfortable. Compare the tension of your shoulders, of your stance, of your sitting, of your upper body. Are you comfortable? Search back in your mind's eye the differences in head movement from when you were fixing your eyes to the head movement, to fixing your eyes to a point straight ahead, to keeping your eyes looking ahead of your movement. Let's do that last one more time. Get your eyes up without your head movement. Look up and keep looking ahead of your head movement. And now looking down and keep your eyes moving downward ahead of your head movement. Was movement easier, quicker, more difficult? Was your eye movement more difficult, easier? How did the rest of you feel? Your shoulders, your neck. This time I want you to close your mouth. If it was or not before, it's the only difference is now you're consciously closing your mouth as far as comfortable. Okay, you're going to lift and look upwards slowly with the mouth closed. Here we go. And now bow the head down as far as comfortable with the mouth closed. Slowly, this is not a race. Slow, go up, mouth closed. Looking ahead, up above you. See if you can go any further comfortably. Now looking down slowly, slowly, slowly moving down. Your mouth closed. And rest. Any difference that you notice? With your mouth closed, one more time, going up, slowly, coming down, slowly. What is the effect of your mouth being closed on your head movement, the ease of movement, the tension of movement, the extension and range of movement. With those in mind, let's do it one more time. Mouth comfortably closed, not locked, but just, here we go, go up. And looking above, extending any more movement, and slowly down, 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 down. And rest. This time we're going to open the mouth. Ah, lift the head slowly. Ah, extend the mouth open as you look higher. And now keeping your jaw open, ah, coming down. Now going up, mouth staying open, jaw extended comfortably, nothing hyperextended. Ah, and now coming down. Now at this point, the jaw probably is in the way as a physical object in your way of going down. On the way up, the jaw extended may change your extension going up. Let's try it. Here we go. Jaw open, going up. Feel the range of motion. Extension, now coming down, ease, and there, your jaw hits your chest, or if you get that, don't get that far, then it's at least down. All right, now we're going to lift and look upward, slowly, as far as comfortable, just slowly. No change, no other direction, just look up. And now bow the head down as far as comfortable. Now without any other directions, no eye or mouth, just up and down. And compare with your memory of the very first time we just did this. Going up, coming down. Is there any difference in the tension of the jaw? Any ease, relaxation, anywhere in the neck? Any more consistent movement, steady movement? Are you thinking of the role of the eyes, or are the eyes just doing whatever they're doing? Up and down. Any release of tension in the shoulders, neck? Any change of sensation, perhaps head pressure? Maybe you had a headache, maybe you now have one. Any stress? How about the arms? How about the way you're sitting? The contact to the chair. Moving your head now, going up. Just take a feel down the spine, how things relate, connect, moving. And that's the end of this first set of just head up and down with eye and mouth movement. The next series, we're going to sing My Country, 'Tis of Thee, Sweet Land of Liberty, of Thee I Sing. Or other familiar tune, anything that you have that's memorable. Now, take your teeth, lightly touch them together, lightly. Okay, now, with other available movement, with your face, your tongue, your lips, your mouth, your nose, your nasal cavities, articulate that song and enunciate that song with your teeth lightly closed. I'll do mine. My country 'tis of thee. I don't know if you can tell, I'm really exaggerated. Okay, I'm going to fall silent. You sing your song with your teeth lightly closed. Use all available movement, face, tongue, lips, mouth, nose, nasal cavities, to articulate and enunciate the song. There we go. Come to a close. This time, with lips together, lightly, using all other available movements, now the jaw movement, as long as the lips don't, you know, the teeth can be apart, the lips don't come apart, lips together, lightly, articulate and enunciate your song. I'll start. So you'll hear that muffle moving the jaw, all kinds of things with the face, the tongue, the lips are immobilized, the mouth, anything in the mouth, the nose, nasal cavities, all fall silent and you sing through. And finish up your singing. This time, take the tip of the tongue, lightly fixed to the roof of the mouth, lightly. Just lift the tip of the tongue, lightly touching the roof of the mouth. Now, using all other available movements, articulate and enunciate your song. I'll start just a little example, the tongue right here. My country is a nation land of liberty. Everything you can do. Here we go. I'll fall silent. Here we go. And finish up your song. Two more to go. Here we go. Now with lips and teeth lightly together, lips and teeth, use your face, tongue, sinus, nose, and nasal cavities to articulate, enunciate, and resonate your song. My country is a here we go. I'll fall silent and go. And finish your song. Alright, this is the end of the video, and when it stops, you have one more task to do. With full use of articulators and resonators to sing, you will full out sing your song right out, still sitting in a comfortable position. Sing your song in full use of your jaw movement, your lips, your teeth, your resonators, all out. And as you do this, it's the final examination of how freely you can do this. Now, before I bow out, if you're a saxophonist, trombonist, cellist, I don't care what you are, instrument, I want you to go to your instrument and play that now and notice the effects, especially of instruments that make contact with the head and the lips and whatever, you know, the neck, even the way that you grip, you know, you have the position of a violin or a viola. This has an effect on anything that makes contact with the head. Okay? This is the end of the session. Have fun exploring. This is the end of a 20-minute session. Thank you very much. This is Alan Gumm, Central Michigan University, Feldenkrais Awareness Through Movement, singing articulation lesson. Bye-bye.